Welcome to More My Love, and I am Shubhashree. You can also find us at our official website, that is www.moremylove.com. So do you often pamper your child? So what I have seen as a mother myself, that every parent pamper their child to a certain extent, but at some time pampering can go wrong. So to understand the fine line between pampering and loving your child, I have brought this video to you so that you can give your best to your child. So before I begin my video, I will request you to subscribe to my channel, because every weekday I come up with videos related to parenting, parent-child relationship, early childhood education, motherhood, and a lot more which revolves around parenting. So to begin with, we will see that how pampering, the word, is taken around when your child is grown up. Sometimes this pampered child is used as a negative word. So it can be good for your child, it can be bad for your child. Everything depends upon the limit or extent by which it is being done. So with the help of 6 points, I will explain to you the do's and don'ts of pampering. So number one is balance their needs versus desire. So, you know, if we can differentiate between the word need and desire, we will understand that need means which we need to survive, and desire is something which we dream of, which we think of it will be better if we can achieve that. So for a child, it is very difficult to understand or do that mathematics, that which is important for me, which is my need and which is my desire. Mostly we see that children, they cry while seeing a toy or going outside with their parents. They see something which attracts them. They can go to any extent to buy that thing. So, you know, when we don't pamper our child, we can make them understand that this is what you don't need right now. You have lots of toys at home. Maybe yesterday or last week or last month you bought something, still you are not playing with that, or you have plenty of it. You really do not require this. So as parents, it is our responsibility to make them understand that what are your needs, which you need to survive or which you need in your life. We are definitely going to give you that. But your desires, it will be fulfilled on special days like your birthday or some occasion. Number two is, sometimes tell your child, narrate to them that how privileged they are from thousands of other kids. So sometimes what happens when your child go to school or meet their friends and they see that the friend has bought something new, maybe a video game or a mobile or a new toy which she is dreaming for many days, and they come back home and ask the same thing from you. So as a parent, you must also show your child the other picture, that there are thousands of kids who are underprivileged, who doesn't get whatever they need in their life. So in that way, when they see, they will be able to balance that we should not run after our desires. It is okay to have desires. We can achieve things when we have desire, but we might not feel sad, or we should not be overwhelmed with our desires. Number three in this video is, don't make your child brand conscious. So what happens when kids are young, they really do not know that what is what. Whenever you are giving them toys or you are buying them books or you are buying them clothes, if you make them brand conscious, they will grow up like that. So what will happen when they grow up is, next time when you buy them something else which is not of that brand or not of that mark, then they will not accept it. So they will not show any kind of gratitude towards you while you are buying them things, because for them at that point of time, what matters is brand. They are no more into that product. They are no more into their desire of getting that thing. Number four is, don't overlook their negativity. Most of the time what happens is, when kids are young, parents and grandparents, they always, cheer them for whatever they do. Kids always come to us to get praised. But you know, sometimes we must say that you haven't done this right. For example, your child come up with a painting, with a drawing, where she has not tried much. For example, she has just scribbled and she thinks that this could be a nice thing to show to my parents because they will praise me anyways. So stop there. If you see that there is some kind of effort which your child has put into it, then of course you must praise your child and encourage them to do it better the next time. But if you don't see any kind of effort which does not attract any kind of praise, then it is better to tell them that this is not something for which I can praise you. You have to do it better, or you can do it in this way so that you can attract praise from others. Because at the end of the day, it is not only about you who is praising your child. If you false praise your child, what will happen tomorrow when she will go out of her house? She will feel bad that why people are not praising me, I'm doing so well. Because you have put that label in front of her that whatever you do, you are doing it so well. Whereas it is not true. So it is always important to put the correct picture in front of your child so that they understand that whatever they are doing, that might be right, that might be wrong, that could be done in some other way, in a better way. So that way they have the acceptance for everything around them. Saying that, our fifth point is don't praise them for whatever they do. As I explained in my last point, when you praise them for whatever small thing they do, if they just scribbled with a color, they went out of the line and they colored it there, and you are praising that, then that might be wrong for your child, because they will be into a continuous notion that whatever I'm doing is right. And then when she goes to the outer world, she will feel that negativity, that whatever I'm doing, people are not accepting it. So make her acceptable to whatever comes her way, and you can only do this if you don't pamper your child too much. So moving to the sixth and the last point in this video, that is, make sure that whatever you give to your child, they are thankful for that. So when there is no gratitude, when you are buying your child tons of different toys and dresses and everything whatever they desire for, and they are not thankful for that, that you are giving them to them, then it will become a problem. Your child will slowly, they will disrespect the things which they have got. They will not value the things which they have got in their life. And slowly as they go into their adulthood, this thing will continue with them and they will continue their life in this way. So as you can see that over pampering your child can be negative for them. So it is better that as parents we understand that what is pampering and what is loving our child. And we also ensure that we teach the same to our children as well, so that they can lead a better life today and a better life tomorrow when they are adults. So that's all for today. If you're liking our videos, please give it a thumbs up, and also let me know in the comments if you have any feedback regarding this video. See you in my next video. Till then, bye-bye.